Let's find out what we need to craft our modular dungeon tiles and walls. Hello fellow gamers and crafters. In this video I'm going to show you what tools we need to craft our modular dungeon tiles, yeah? And also what we need to craft the walls. Stay with me. So the first thing you're going to need is some space to cut, obviously, but please protect that space with a self-healing cutting mat. Get one that is big, probably as big as you can fit in. Next thing you will need is cutter. So either you take the cheap one, which is like $2, but I wouldn't recommend it. I recommend take the more expensive one. It's around $10, but especially the fixing wheel really helps with everything. What you want to have is a metal ruler. And I cannot stress this, a metal ruler. It makes a real difference. I would not have thought so myself. I used a plastic one first, and metal is 10 times better. What else are you going to need is some XPS. Since we are making XPS foam tiles, obviously we are going to need some XPS. I cannot really tell you how much this cost, because I got mine for free. It's extruded polystyrene, and it's mostly used for home insulation. So you can get it from there, but you can also find it in like the really big arts and crafts stores, so you can get that one. And since you don't want to cut that all with the knife, next thing you want to have is the hot wire foam cutter. This one is, to be honest, a bit more expensive. I got lucky, I found mine cheap on eBay. There are people who build these things. There's nothing to complain about this one. It's really neat. It has everything you need. I made some marks on it myself. And I wish it would be a little bit hotter, but it certainly does the job. Next thing you need is cardstock. Or I was really looking for it in Germany for quite some time. It's actually in Germany called Buchbinderpappe. Or at least I'm pretty sure that the corrugated cardboard is this. This one is 1.5 millimeter thick. You can also buy 2 millimeter thick ones. Both will work fine. There is one detail, so, and I have to stress it a little bit. There's a slick version, which is like super plain. And there's one that's a bit more rough. I made the mistake of buying the slick one. Don't do that. Buy the roughed up one. Because the problem with the slick one is it has like a tiny sheet of corrugation on top of it. Maybe you can see it now. And this has a tendency to come off. So don't do that. Buy one that does not have this extra slick with it. It will help you a lot. The one I bought was originally 70 by 50 centimeter. And the piece you see here is practically what's left of it. So you won't even need a complete one for that. You're also going to need something where you can measure an angle with. This is like really something cheap that I still had left over from school. I would recommend you also get one of these metal straight edges. It helps a lot. Otherwise, this is a minimum version. What you will also need is PVA or white glue. In Germany it's called Holzleim. That's the easiest you can get. We need it because it dries clear and does not add extra volume. And that's exactly what we want to have when we build the card lock system. Because you can see the cardstock is glued in between the XPS tiles. Therefore, white glue. Next thing you need will be acrylic paints.
white one, black one, and some off-color white.
Mine is cream, but beige, agouti, anything will do. Get two big packs. I also got a really nice color range from my craft store, where I got for 12 bucks, I got like 20 colors. Super cool. With that, you want to have a brush. And you want to have a big brush. You don't want anything small. 2.5 centimeters is perfect and will really help you in doing the job quickly. The infamous Mod Podge. Problem is Mod Podge, I don't even know if you get it in Germany. I found this one, which practically does the same. It's called Serviettenkleber or Napkin Glue. It's usually used to glue napkin to, I don't know, who glues napkins to anything? Okay, but this is the stuff. This is a German Mod Podge. Last but not least, you will need some aluminium foil to give the whole thing some texture. There are some extra things that you can use. One is another use of another bottle of normal glue. This one is ink. It comes from the Black Magic recipe for better washes, and it's actually good. It's really, I would recommend it. And what every crafter of course also needs is some super glue, always helpful when crafting. To add some structure to our modular dungeon tiles, it's also helpful if you have a soldering iron. You see, mine is like really cheap and old. If you don't have it, it doesn't matter. You can also do it with a pen if you like that better.
So, these are all the tools we need. And I try to put a price tag on them if I find one. And I think we are ready to craft our modular dungeon tiles. So, see you in the next video. And now it's your turn to craft.